oncolon virus response. After deliberations, I've decided, in the interest of public safety and the protection of our population, to review the public gathering advisories earlier announced as follows. Firstly, all public gatherings, including conferences, workshops, funerals, festivals, political rallies, sporting events, and religious events such as services in churches and mosques have been suspended for the next 4 weeks. Private burials are permitted, but with limited numbers, not exceeding 25 in attendance. Secondly, all universities, senior high schools, and basic schools, are in public and private schools, will be closed Monday, 16th of March, 2020, till further notice. The Minister of Education, in collaboration with the Minister of Communication, has been tasked to roll out distance learning programs. However, VECE and WASI candidates will be allowed to attend school to prepare for their examinations under the prescribed social distancing protocols. Thirdly, the Government of Ghana's travel advisory issued earlier today should be observed as announced. Fourthly, businesses and other workplaces can continue to operate, but should observe prescribed social distancing between patrons and staff. Fifthly, establishments such as supermarkets, shopping malls, restaurants, nightclubs, hotels and drinking spots should observe enhanced hygiene procedures by providing, amongst others, hand sanitizers, running water and soap for washing of hands. Sixthly, the Ministry of Transport should work with the transport unions and private and public transport operators to ensure enhanced hygienic conditions in all vehicles and terminals by providing, amongst others, hand sanitizers, running water, and soap for washing of hands. And seventh, the Ministry of Local Government and Rural Development should coordinate with the Metropolitan, Municipal, and District Assemblies measures to enhance conditions of hygiene in markets across the country. Additionally, as the experts conduct contact tracing, I appeal to all to cooperate with them to ensure that persons who have come into contact with positive cases are identified and supported. I've directed the Attorney General to submit immediately to Parliament emergency legislation in accordance with Article 21(4)(c) and D of the Constitution of the Republic to embody these measures. And I've further directed the Minister for Health to exercise his powers under Section 169 of the Public Health Act 2012, Act 851, by the immediate issuance of an executive instrument to govern the relevant profession. I call upon Parliament to support the executive in this national endeavor. As I said earlier,